Now, belonging to the sector that you are, the pharmacy sector, some of you may join the corporate sector, some of you may go in for research, right? So, but basically the what I'm going to talk today will help you in all the aspects, wherever you go, maybe corporate sector or maybe for research or whatever. So without much ado, can I request someone if I can share my screen? Will I be able to share my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm going to switch off my video for now and I'll be sharing my screen. Okay, I've got a small presentation prepared so that you'll get an idea about what... Can everybody see?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So today I have been requested to speak on basically behavior at the corporate, not the corporate behavior, but behavior at the corporate. So many of you are in your first year and it's still, I believe, 3 more years for you to actually think about how to, what to do and what your career is going, career path is going to take you. But I feel this is the right time to tell you and talk to you about what exactly is at the corporate, how to behave, and what are the policies that govern you, and basically what is the difference between what you're doing now and once you start your career, what it will be. I'm not able to go into the slide share mode, so apologies for that. Can you see this? I'm just going to increase this a bit. Is it okay now?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello? Yeah. So yes. The objective today is for you to understand what is the difference between college and work life. What is the culture at the workplace and the do's and don'ts at the workplace, right? So I hope this will be enough as a beginning for you. And of course, in between, I'll be sharing some stories or some anecdotes with you. So now, since it's such a huge forum, but I'm going to give you a couple of minutes to put it into chat, you know, what do you think of the following at workplace? So when you think of environment at the workplace, what do you normally think of? Can I get answers in the chat quickly? When we say the environment at the workplace is so and so, what do you think the environment at the workplace is? Any one or two chat answers? Come on, all smart people. Helpful environment. Very good. Debanita Dash. Jash, thank you. Anyone else? Positive environment. Very good. So when you think of assignments, what do you think of assignments? Yes, Surbhi, friendly. Good. Now on assignments, what do you think when we say assignments at the workplace? Assignments? Yeah, we have shifted to assignments, Amit. Projects. Okay. Delivered to be on time. Very good. Clean and clear. Excellent. So I don't know why I'm taking this session today, Dr. Asha. People seem to know everything. So they are anticipating what I'm going to speak. So follow the deadlines. Exactly. Right. Then when the third thing you come to is the interpersonal relationships. What do you think when you talk of interpersonal relationships at the workplace? Anyone? Friendly. Okay. Again, friendly. Yes. Healthy. Very good. Shambhavi, very good word. Healthy. Communication skills. Give respect. Taking respect. Respect. Supportive. Cordial. Excellent answers, all of you. I don't think my session is needed. Excellent answers. Then conduct. I think interpersonal relationship and conduct, there is a slight difference between it. Right? Happiness. Good. What about conduct? Anyone can say what should be the conduct at workplace? Anyone? Supportive conduct. Okay. What else? Coordinative, positivity, cooperative. Okay. See, conduct basically is how you conduct yourself at workplace. You know, how you behave at workplace. So when you think the following at workplace, code of ethics, good, good. Everyone is read and come. So very good. So my lecture becomes easier. So conduct basically means how you conduct yourself at workplace. Are you professional? Are you the right mix of professional? No, video should be off. I'm going to keep my video off. So are you the right thing of professional and this? Hey, but can you see my presentation? Video is off, but presentation is seen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. So this is conduct really. Okay. I'm going to the next slide. Now, how will it be different from colleges, right? It will be different from college, right? So what you're doing at college and what you'll be doing at workplace. So what time does your college begin, Dr. Asha?
Ma'am, 10 a.m.
And yeah. Still online lectures are there?
Ma'am, some students online and some offline.
Okay, so I'm going to ask a question again. You'll be wondering why I'm asking so many questions. But to come to college at 10 o'clock, what time do you leave your house? You can answer in chat. What time do you leave your house? What time do you wake up? Anyone? And don't give very tailor answers, okay? Give truthful answers. Wake up at 6 a.m. 9:30. Oh, who's that? I love that answer. 9:30 a.m. We leave at 9. Okay, 9 a.m. Wake up at 7. Good, good. But no one just, for online session, no one just wakes up at 9:45 and opens your laptop and sits for online session. No one? I don't believe it. I've got a son your age. Me, Kaustubh. Good, good, good. So 10 o'clock session, you get up at 9:30 and sit for the session, right? Oh, many, many. So this is college life. Absolutely, this is college life. Wake up at 8:30. Everything is in your hands. So how will it be different when you're talking of your professional life? So this is the one.
Sorry to disturb you, ma'am. Can you just make the slide share full screen?
Yeah, I'm trying to, but I'm not able to move it. Okay, anyway, I'll try to make it full screen.
Yes.
Now can you see? I'll just have to come back to the regular slide and then move the slide. Is this visible now?
Not as a slide share.
But it's, what is it? Only the slide can be seen. So I think there's some problem in the setting. So what I'll do is I'll just increase the... I'm stopping the share and starting again.
Yes.
I'm going to increase the font. Okay.
Ma'am, now it's fine.
It's fine? Okay. Yes. So, campus. So, absent, who can, absenteeism and tardiness are tolerated with negligible punishment. Is it true? This I would like to ask the teachers. True? Right, no? Okay. Then change is slow and predictable. Changes in terms of whatever changes are taking place in the campus, in terms of your policies would be there, or because there are a lot of factors governing it. The governance structure at campuses is different, right? When appearance and etiquette have little bearing on the academic performance. Again, true. You can come in your short. I don't think your college may allow shorts, but many colleges, many residential institutes, jeans and t-shirts and different type of dressing is allowed. And appearance and etiquette have little bearing on the academic performance. The expert is the professor. Clear, no? I think you'd all agree that here the professor normally, you consider the professor or your guide as the expert. Scope of assignments remain the same. So you're given certain assignments. Yes, Shruti, I'll come to you. You're given certain assignments and the scope remains the same. Friends, you select your own friends in college, right? You get along well with certain people. You become part of a group depending on your passion, depending on your hobbies. So you have a right to select your own friends. Communication focus is limited. I wouldn't say limited in a way, but there's not much focus on... You don't mark your T's, I's and T's. You don't dot your I's or mark your cross your T's. So communication is bindas, if that's a word I can use. And personal goal is to get a degree. So why you're joining colleges? To get a degree in the first instance and then go ahead and, think of a career in the third, fourth year. And many of you have thought, okay, I'll go to pharmacy and then I'll do this, I'll do that. Many of you aspired to be doctors first and then decided, okay, that is not the field for me. I'll go into pharmacy. So this could be the campus current state. Okay. Can you hear me? Someone messaged me to speak loud. Can you hear me, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
And Shruti had raised her hand. Shruti, what was your question? Can you type in chat? Someone had raised their hand, no? Shruti, I believe. No question, or by mistake she raised the hand. Okay, can I go ahead?
Yes, ma'am.
So absenteeism, no ma'am, no question. Okay, Shruti. Absenteeism and tardiness can lead to disciplinary action, notice, suspension, termination. See, now again, because of this COVID, one thing the corporate have also learned is the blended form of working. Blended in terms of a mix of online and in-person working. But there are certain domains in corporate where you have to be there in person. For example, shop floor, some R&D departments, some departments, the finished goods ones or the supply chain ones. You have to be there. So absenteeism and tardiness without information. There would be people who will be coming. Your timing is 9 o'clock, but they'll come at 9:15 every day. So that can really bring to notice that you are a late comer all the time. And continuous without any reason could lead to notice, suspension and termination, right? Then change is very fast and unpredictable. It always is, you know, it is on the move. Like, it depends on the orders that you've got. It depends on the project that you're working on. It depends on the deadlines that are there. And the projects are also dynamic. So you have to get information from the different things. You're working in a multi-stakeholder atmosphere. Appearance and etiquette have a significant impact. Absolutely. See, here, like I told you cannot come in torn jeans here, right? Your appearance and etiquette, each organization will have their own policies. And each policy would also contain the code of conduct. And in that code of conduct will be the dressing. Allowed dressing. So many organizations, manufacturing industries are quite formal in a way. They have a formal code of conduct. But on Saturdays, on Fridays or weekends, some relaxation is allowed. But again, that doesn't mean torn jeans. Your jeans will not be torn. You know, and you cannot wear t-shirts with inane sayings on it. So some organization would prefer collared t-shirts. Some organization would prefer no wearing t-shirts or something like that. Jeans and a smart half shirt is okay. Smart casuals, what you call. So appearance and etiquette also have a significant impact, like I said. Then there is no particular expert here. You know, it's not that you're senior. You will have a group of experts. Because the kind of work you're doing, you may have to interact with different people. And with different people, when you interact, they are the experts in their domain. So, for example, if I have to put something on social media, then I have to connect with someone who is in the corporate communication team. So that becomes the expert for me. Or if I have to go ask about some product description to someone. So I have to go to someone in the production team or the R&D team. So the expert can be any employee here. Teamwork is the norm. You cannot work in silos. You may have different projects where you are responsible for a certain aspect of the project, but in the end of the day, everything will come together like a jigsaw puzzle. So teamwork is the norm, and how you work in a team is also very important here. You have no choice of co-workers. You cannot decide that main iske baju mein nahi baithunga, meri iske saath jamti nahi, I'll not have lunch with him. Ye college mein hota hai, waise nahi ho sakta hai. Communication is very broad. And personal goals need to gel with the organizational goals. That is, I think, self-explanatory. Here, I'd like to pause and say, we have interacted with a lot of incoming college youth, and Forbes Marshall conducts a lot of three-month courses for students who've just passed out of college, manufacturing courses. So certification courses. So they get on-the-job training, and they're based out of our factory in Chakan, and they get to come in regularly like our employees and go out at the same time. So I have seen being part of various panels in the department in Forbes Marshall itself, I have seen a lot of things which go around which they still behave as though they're in college. So for example, if they see a girl, sorry boys, here I have to point out this way, but if they see a girl coming across, walking towards them, they have a habit of sizing her up, you know, what dress she's wearing, how she's looking. College may be aajkal nahi chalta hai. Maybe chalta hoga, but aajkal I don't think it is. But in corporate, you do that, sexual harassment. you know, immediately someone might complain that sexual harassment. Then there is certain things where you have to have your own borderlines. You have to have your compartments, internal compartments, where you cannot go beyond this. Another simple thing is I've seen a lot of youth having their own ringtones. You know, I don't know, caller tunes, they call or ringtones. But we generally suggest to our people that your phone needs to be silent if it is having a particular ringtone, or your phone needs to, you should not have any, you should have a neutral ringtone or something which is not indicative of anything. I'll give you an example here. There was this one instance, I've always shared it with Dr. Asha and the team, where at the workplace there was this particular ringtone, and these two friends used to constantly play that caller ID purposely, on purpose. So the lady sitting opposite them got offended and she complained to the HR. So ye kya hoga? Kyun HR ko, why the complaint should go? No, apparently the ringtone was that Katrina Kaif song, Sheila Ki Jawani, and the girl's name was Sheila. So she took affront and she complained to the HR. And they were pulled up and it went into their files that they did this thing on purpose. So you would not even think of such things happening in college, right? And corporate, gender diversity is a huge thing. Equal treatment between men and women. You will have engineers or you will have girls who are equally qualified as you. Sometimes you will have your senior managers who's a lady. So there is huge, I would say, importance on gender equality at the corporate. And there are people who are working towards it. If any particular department they feel is not equal in gender, there are more men than women or more women than men, then there are efforts made to see why, and there are efforts made to see that they come up to their goals, what they are set up. No? So there's a huge thing on gender equality, where the payment parity is checked, where safety at workplace is checked. Everything is checked for the gender equality. So this is in short what would be the do's and don'ts at the corporate level. But like I said, don't have to get scared by it, but you should be prepared. Okay, life will change. It is not going to be the same. I have heard of people, boys, like I said, I've got a son your age. Boys calling each other by gali. Gali se bulate, naam nahi lete. So you cannot do that here. You just cannot do it here. Right? So it's a big don't. I'll have to go back and then... I think there's some problem with the screen sharing. I don't know whether it is me or... I'll just check. Hmm? So, can you see this slide?
Yes, ma'am. We are able to see the slide, ma'am.
Yeah.
Roles and responsibilities
and learning.
Yes, ma'am.
So, these are the terms you'll hear a lot in the corporate world, you know. Rules, responsibility, leadership, ethical practices, teamwork, deadline. Someone mentioned deadline also. And competition and coordination. So, basically, rules and responsibilities, like I said, rules are the ones which will be laid down by the corporate for you. That do's and don'ts, the ethical code of conduct, the how you're supposed to behave. The moment you enter the gate, your behavior is governed by the code of conduct, right? Then the responsibilities, you are responsible for your own domain. You are responsible for if you've been given a certain responsibility. For example, nowadays many corporates have their key performance indicators and the key responsibility and actionables. So KRA is what you call it. So these are given to you. These are developed for you in sitting with you. They have developed for you, with you, along with you. They are co-designed. So your responsibilities are also charted, and every quarter the assessment is done where there were gaps, and if the gaps, what learnings are there. And even here, again, you get a lot of chance to learn. You get a lot of chance to upskill yourself in the various other things. You can upskill yourself also in a huge way. Then leadership, of course, you get a chance to, you know, various team activities are also there. It may be dealing with work or without. There are a lot of co-curricular activities also happening at the workplace. So you're given enough exposure to explore your hobbies, to look at leadership roles within the organization, and you're supported by the organization, and most of the organizations do that. Ethical practice is something which is very viewed very seriously by most organizations, because especially an organization like ours, I can say for it, that if you are not up to the performance, your performance, or you're not up to your target, you'll be forgiven once, you'll be forgiven twice. Help will be given to you if you need help to achieve your targets or achieve your deadlines. But if you're caught, your integrity is compromised, then no help is given. You are out that same day. So now that is the importance many corporates give on integrity and ethical practices. In teamwork, we mentioned, deadline we mentioned, and I think competition coordination is very clear from the words itself. Then this is another thing, we in the chat we read a lot, no? Give respect, give respect. So respect is something, when you are in a corporate, same to you as your college life also, you will be having peers. That means someone you are same level, same band they call in corporates, grade, same grade they call. So you'll have peers, you have subordinates, who may be your juniors, who may be trainees, who may be interns who are coming, and you'll have seniors, of course. So most common and is that give respect. We will never even talk to our housekeeping staff without giving respect. So give respect also talks a lot about your own culture and your own value system, right? Then for the peers, it is balanced professional life and social life. In with peers, it is also you get along well, you form friendships in at workplace, you socialize with the peers. But how can you balance professional life and social life? Here again, if you are in a multi-gender group, there again, you'll be governed by certain laws, where the laws of sexual harassment will come in play, where the laws of ethical behavior will come in play. So all this would come in play there. Then for subordinates, always remember your first day at office. How did you feel? How worried you were? How excited you were? And that is how you can empathize with the subordinates also. And with senior, you should behave with company culture. Now, many places you'll have people calling sir, madam. But in companies like ours, even the owners of the company, we are calling by name. So the company culture will be different at different organizations. What you can call them, how you can address them really. And some places, like I said, is sir hai, boss bulate hai kuch log. But many organizations now don't have this sir, madam culture. Then behavior at workplace again. Sorry. Professional attributes come in play, and you are given lot of you are given a lot of scope to improve, and you are given a lot of scope to upskill yourself, right? If someone finds, various organizations nowadays also have tie-ups with institutions. Now Cobes Machine has tie-ups with IITs, where our internal people are given opportunities to work on projects with IITs and also work on different models, and also upskill yourself by doing 6 month and 1 year courses with them, which are co-paid or company pays for it. When displaying honesty and integrity is one, maintain confidentiality. So many a times you are going to be in certain positions where confidentiality will have to be maintained. For example, you are part of a team. Your friend from college, or you made friends with someone who's part of some other team. So many a times it so happens that whatever is discussed in your team should not go out of your team, especially related to work, or any incidents is taking place. You have to maintain confidentiality. There are certain aspects. This is, where this is more logical is that confidential. If someone is working in HR department, so HR has access to a lot of information. HR has access to a lot of things, the salaries information, the information on promotions, incoming promotions. So even if you are friends with an HR person, he or she is expected to maintain confidentiality and not share with you before it is opened up, right? So confidentiality has to be maintained, and professionalism, we've spoken enough about it. then certain do's and don'ts, I feel I should just touch upon it. So use lunchtime to establish good working relationships. Really do that, because you know, during lunchtime, it is not only you're having lunch with your own team, but you also sometimes have lunch, you meet other people different, working in different departments. So you get to know them, you have a good working relationships with them. Follow Professor Desing norms, we know that. Know the norms of lunchtime. Many a times, bigger, larger organizations like ours will have lunchtime planned. This department will go at this time, this department will go at the time. Are you allowed to eat at your desk? Now, because of COVID, many of us are not allowed to eat at our desk. So many things are like that. Then demonstrate your interest in the business. Understand not only what your department is about, but understand the bigger picture. Which is the organization, if it is supply, if it is any other pharmaceutical company, what is the interest, where are the global branches, where are they, what is the sales, what is the, even if you are in R&D, you should at least know what is the business or the economics of your organization. Then deliver all on commitment, be ready to take notes. You know, I've seen many people just come into meetings and they don't take notes, or I have also seen that in the garb of taking notes, they are chatting on their mobile. So please don't do that. Don't be scared. Even today I take notes at this seniority also. Don't feel shy to take notes, write down things. Even my director, who's the owner of this company, she even now she takes notes. And again, professional, you can imagine how many times I've written professional. So please see how serious it is. Don't make loud noises or phone conversations laughter. If there's a personal call, always go out of the department and take it at a different place. It's a personal or a professional confidential call, please do that. Don't gossip. You hear something here and there, you don't need to engage in gossip. That again sends a very wrong precedent. Engage in controversial conversations like politics and religion. This is very, 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 very important, because most corporates will proclaim that they are a political. You know, as corporates, they will not support any religion, they will not support any. They'll be a political or they'll be neutral for all these things. Similarly, if I'm aligned to a certain political party, if I'm following certain religion, I don't need to have it in conversation. It is personal for me. You don't need to have debates on that or such things. Don't attend to personal working office. This is a big, big, big don't. Many IT companies do not allow you to even open certain websites, right? Even some websites, I have seen people who would shop on Amazon, who would open Facebook in office. So try and avoid that. Have ego clashes. Don't have ego clashes at all. Not good for the team also.
Ma'am, I request you to be a little louder.
Yeah, now can you hear me?
Yes, yes. Yeah. Better, ma'am.
So forget to keep a calendar. Don't forget to keep a calendar or diary. Because you know, nowadays Google Calendar is really very useful. Otherwise you'll end up confusing your dates of meetings and other things. I think the diary spelling is wrong. Please, sorry for that. Then don't be late. Don't express anger physically. Don't show anger. What you're doing here is nothing personal. You're working for the organization. So if you're angry, there are ways in which to do. You can mediate. You can get someone to mediate for you, right? And don't lash out when under stress. If you are undergoing any stress, it's always better to talk to your HR or someone close to you or your manager about it. So lastly, I would just like to say, don't fear change. Embrace it. And there's a lovely life out there, which will really, you know, you will be stepping into a new world. After now is your world, you enjoy these 3-4 years of college. But afterwards, it's a different world altogether, but it's a lovely world. And I have always found out, you know, that if you love what you're doing, it does not work. So always try to get a job or get something, make a career in something which you're loving and not you're not forced into it. Right? And thank you. Any questions? If any, I'll take it.
If there are anything? Any questions, a student can post it in the chat box.
Yes, please. Yes, please. Questions?
Yeah, ma'am. We have a question.
No.
From Janvi, that can you tell the dress code again, ma'am?
Okay, I'll do that. I think I'll just take the, you know, first is, I think Varsha had a question. What qualities are a must have for a project leader? I feel, Varsha, see, a project leader, once you come into the corporate, it's not that the first project you get, you'll be a project leader. So you'll get to learn. And like I mentioned, being professional, being able to work in a team, being able to collaborate with different stakeholders, having gained the respect of your team, in your colleagues, peers, superiors, and juniors, in terms of your knowledge, in terms of your behavior, in terms of the way you conduct yourself, all this could be good qualities for a project leader. Because once you say it's a project leader, you need to have people follow you, right? So that way. Then Mohit is asked regarding dress code. What about hair? Mohit, regarding dress code, hair, do you have long hair? Okay. So I think if you have very long hair, tying it in a bun is not a problem. You can tie a ponytail or a bun. But if you have shoulder length hair and you're keeping it open, I think your HR may have problems to it. Then does this answer your question? I hope yes. मैम हम स्मार्ट वर्क करके भी सक्सेस अचीव कर सकते हैं क्या एंड हार्ड वर्क एब्सोल्युटली स्मार्ट वर्क एंड हार्ड वर्क बोथ आर बोथ गो हैंड इन हैंड ईच इज इनकम्प्लीट विदाउट अदर स्मार्ट वर्क सिर्फ स्मार्ट वर्क करोगे ना तो यू विल गो ओनली अप टू अ सर्टेन लेवल और सिर्फ हार्ड वर्क करोगे तो भी एक ही लेवल तक एक ही स्टेशन तक जा पाओगे यू कंबाइन बोथ in the right your pharmacy students so in the right formula you will do great then can you tell me the dress code again man okay Janavi the dress code is for example if you see us at Forbes Marshall for us the dress code is western formals indian formals and presentable so I cannot wear huge jhumkas and come to office right or I cannot wear crop tops and come to office So Western formals would be a nice Western top and formal trousers. Jeans are not allowed. Some organizations allow jeans on Fridays. That is the last working day of the week. But again, these jeans would be teamed with a good blouse or a collared t-shirt. Again, this depends on the organization. Then Ruchita, any do's and don'ts for interview? Ruchita, that is a session. I think Dr. Asha, this needs another session really for interviews. And I'm sure they'll do something, the college will plan something before your placements, right? Does piercing and tattoo affect our personality job profile? I don't think so. As long as your tattoos are not of Ankita, right? Okay, as long as your tattoos are not, what I would say, displeasing or they're not very antisocial. Or they are not anything to do with nudity or something like that. So it doesn't really affect your personality or job profile. But again, having said that, if you're going to an interview with your, again, the job which you're applying for makes a lot of difference. If you're applying in an informal sector, so I'm sure this will not matter at all. But if you've got piercing in the wrong places, if your tongue is pierced or something, I'm not sure how organizations would take it, right?